These new weight loss medications are hailed as game-changing wonder drugs. But just how safe and effective are they? Why do most people stop taking them within a few months? Why does weight loss plateau? And what happens when you quit? I answer all these questions and more in this video series on Ozempic and other GLP-1 drugs. The new class of weight loss drugs, GLP-1 agonists like Ozempic, have received enormous, almost unprecedented attention in the mainstream media. They've been called the medical sensation of the decade. The business press was practically giddy, declaring the end of the obesity epidemic. The enthusiasm is shared in the medical literature, with headlines suggesting they are game-changing revolutions in the treatment of obesity, therapeutic wizard miracle drugs that are hugely effective in the treatment of obesity. But history is littered with failed weight loss wonder drugs. Every other year or so, an anti-obesity medication that had been approved to be safe and effective has had to be withdrawn from the market after serious side effects emerged. See my video on the subject for the whole sordid story of how these so-called medical magic bullets have turned out to be blanks or worse. To date, most weight loss drugs, despite their initial approval, have since been pulled from the market for unforeseen side effects that have turned them into a public threat. From rainbow diet pills packed with amphetamines that were marketed to women, to the rise and fall of fen-phen, which triggered catastrophic heart and lung conditions, history is beset by failures to find safe, successful weight loss drugs. Aminorex was a widely prescribed appetite suppressant before it was pulled for causing lung damage. 18 million Americans were on fen-phen before it was pulled for causing severe damage to heart valves. Meridia was pulled for heart attacks and strokes, and Acomplia for psychiatric side effects, including suicide. Belvic was withdrawn in 2020 after it was recognized that it may have been causing cancer for the 8 years it had been on the market. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration initially rejected it after it appeared to cause several types of tumors in rats, but when a one-year human trial showed no apparent cancer, it was approved and went on to become one of the most frequently prescribed weight loss drugs. But when people were actually on it for a few years, notably high rates of colorectal cancer, pancreatic cancer, and lung cancer popped up, so oopsie, it was pulled from the market. The news was met with surprise and confusion among obesity medicine specialists who had been prescribing the drug to help patients achieve and sustain the health benefits of weight loss. It was particularly jarring because the drug was generally regarded as being so safe until it wasn't. Or take Benflurex. Like Ozempic, another diabetes drug repurposed as an appetite suppressant, it caused hundreds of deaths, but didn't get pulled for 33 years. The drug company knew about the risks, but covered them up. Judges concluded that the drug company's priority was systematically given to preserving its own economic interests over the safety of the drug's consumers. So historically, anti-obesity drugs have been kind of like cigarettes. Like smoking, popping these pills can cause you to lose weight, but at what cost? The goal of weight loss is not to fit into a skinnier casket, but they don't even work very well. The current crop of approved meds include Quizmia, a combination of phentermine, the fen and fen-phen, and topiramate, a drug that can cause seizures if you abruptly stop taking it. This drug combination was explicitly rejected multiple times for safety reasons in Europe, but remains for sale in the United States. Contrave is another option if you choose to ignore its own black box warning about a potential increase in suicidal thoughts. Ally, also sold as Zenical, is the final choice. That's the drug that blocks fat absorption and causes side effects such as flatus with discharge. The drug evidently, quote, forces the patient to use diapers and to know the location of all the bathrooms in the neighborhood in an attempt to limit the consequences of urgent leakage of oily fecal matter, end quote. All for a grand total of just 3% weight loss. All that mess to go from like 300 pounds down to 291 pounds. As you can see, older weight loss medications only achieved about 5% weight loss, whereas the newfangled GLP-1 agonists like Ozempic can cause an average of 6% weight loss. Now, this is because they were averaging the effects of some of the older GLP-1 agonists like Saxenda or Byetta. Semaglutide, sold as Ozempic for diabetes and Wegovy for weight loss, causes about twice that. And now there's tirzepatide, sold as Mounjaro or Zepbound, which gets you closer to what you see with bariatric surgery. So while the older obesity medications achieve weight losses in the 5-10% range, the new generation of agents are more in the 15-20% range, about triple what we saw in many of the older drugs. So for about a half a century, there's been healthy skepticism about new kid-on-the-block obesity drugs promising profound weight loss, only to see one after another fail and flop. But today, this historical narrative could be in flux. How well do these GLP-1 agonist drugs really work? How do they work? How long do they work? What are the short-term side effects? What are the long-term side effects? Are there cheaper, safer, natural alternatives to boost GLP-1 with diet and lifestyle? What even is GLP-1? I'll cover all those topics and more next.